Hey guys, make this your last friendly. We're gonna probably go ahead and get started with the bracket since it's already after 8. So yeah, you're playing L, and he's out there, and Pac-Man, me and Pac-Man are playing Say and Scorch Slayer and J-Boy and B2. Okay, yeah, we, like, some of the other people that were normally here, they planned, they said they weren't going to be here tonight, so, yeah, that kind of pushed things back a little bit, yeah. Hey Zay, how do I connect to the Wi-Fi? Like to the So, we're going to go ahead and get started with the Smash Station 55 bracket. Once again, thanks for joining us today, guys. For the first match on stream, I got 501 and L. Once I get connected to the Wi-Fi, I can let people know we're live because the Wi-Fi is being kind of janky.
He's actually watching.
Wait, who?
Someone named Leo Oyama. I've played on him online and he found my.
Yo, that's hype. That's actually pretty hype. He actually found you. It's like you're streaming right now. We're like all live right now. Hey Pac-Man, me and you are playing, but I'm gonna wait and push the third match, and that one's gonna be Zay and Sporks Slayer. I'm not sure how B2's gonna use. Hey Zay, if you wanna ask B2 if you wanna play on that setup, on his setup for a bracket, if not, it's okay. We just need a second setup, and I don't want to. I want a friendly setup to be up so he can play, and I want a bracket. Yeah, I know. I just want to make sure everyone's able to play. And you're playing J-Moto. What are the odds, right? It's only 8 people in bracket. So, like, yeah, right. Yeah. Top 8 right there, so congrats. All matches are streamed? That actually would be cool, because I'm actually trying to like cut the matches now.
Hey,
Oh, he's right here. Yeah, you're, hey, Jay Miller, you're playing B2 for your first match. Good luck. You gotta be willing to save that jump if you're off stage. Listen, man, if you're not willing, then you're just gonna die every time. Yo, Zay, you're playing Sports Slayer when you're ready. When there's a, well, yeah. When you're ready. Hey, Sports Slayer, I think we're just going to make that the third setup over there. That's just going to be for friendlies. So that, you know, people can just play friendlies whenever they want to. So, yeah, if you want to play friendlies while you're waiting, you're more than welcome to. If you guys want to go by the like the standard rule set, let me know. I can hit you up with it. You got it? Okay.
When you guys are ready, you guys can play on stage.
Disrespect, son. Disrespect. I'm not terrible. That's not your game. You're good. Wait, what? Yeah, boy. Let's do this.
Oh.
I know the beginner stage or the starter stages are Battlefield, Final Dash, Town and City, Smashville, and Lilac. Yeah, I think that's it. I hear John's. I hear potential John. The other ones are right. Wait, hold on. Listen, man.
The process of making them horizontal.
Letting people know the stream's up. because the link that we were connected to in the Southwest Virginia Discord, like, they had like a little like notifier whenever we go live, but it's not connected for some reason. So I'm just letting people know. It's all good. Keep saying. Three, two, one, go! That shit's messed up. But it's all good. We're good. What's going on, guys? So we're here with Smash Station 55, round one. We have Zayn Sports Slayer, round two. I don't really know. This matchup looks really, it's definitely like a really real matchup, because it's like no one plays Ice Climbers, and there's like only a handful of Ridley mains out there. Sports Slayer being a Toon Link main. Oh, there's a good dash attack coming from Sports Slayer, killing Popo. The main one out of the chaotic duo here. I'm sorry, I don't personally like Ice Climbers. They're just too rambunctious. I like how they do their grab combos. But definitely, giving him props, because honestly, there's not that many Ice Climber mains out there. But yeah, this is definitely looking like a really weird matchup. So, because they went with the side B punish right there. Oh wow, that was a good edge. Calling out Nana's options right there, and there goes Nana. Popo, Sopo versus Ridley. Yeah, Sopo, I personally think that Sopo can really, make a comeback, but honestly, Sopo is not usually a good option, or at least a good match for things, but I don't know. I think Sopo is definitely something you need to watch out for. But Zayn's last stock here, if he can keep, find a way to keep Sports Slayer off stage, he could probably go for a punish and take the next stock, even this up. Hey, what was that set?
What was that set? 2-1.
2-1? Okay. Definitely good games for both players. I can't get bracket running on the laptop because it keeps making the stream lag, so I'm just on my phone.
Did you change the bracket password? No, not bracket. Did you change the challenge password? Because I can't log in
from that. No, it's the same. Have you tried logging in with sync _ heroes and then sync 16? It's just lowercase sync, everything lowercase, and then just 16.
So sync heroes,
let me try that. Hey, Sportsley, you play B2? You play B2 next?
But it's up to you. You want to wait or you can play now. It's up to you. I think he wants to play a match real quick. We have time for it, so whenever you want to do it, it's fine.
Hey, Pac-Man, we play when you're ready. Say, are you ready for your second match? Yeah, if you're ready to play, you can. Hey, J-Moto, would you like to play your second match? Would you like to play your second match? All right. Yeah, you can play on stream. You play Zay on stream. Yeah. Yeah, there you go. I just say use sync_heroes instead of sync_heroes, sync_heroes at Gmail. I mean, you can use Gmail. If you ever want to, though, by the way, like, feel free to check the email, like the Gmail thing. Because sometimes we do get messages from people, random.
What's the password to the thing?
Same thing.
So
sync_heroes_16. Well, I mean, it's, well, the Gmail is like sync_heroes.
Yeah, I got the Gmail.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, it's sync here. It's sync 16. Just it's same password. Wait. No, sync, lowercase sync, whole thing sync, lowercase, and then 16.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Anywhere.
Yeah. You're good. Yo, B2. Yo, your next match is against Sports Slayer. You play Sports Slayer. I did not say that, sir. I said clearly. All right.
Who is that?
Sports Slayer is right beside you. Yeah. We only have like 9 people here. Yeah. So, what's that? Oh yeah. You're gonna be once Pac-Man's. I don't even think I'm playing a set. I play Pac-Man, and whoever wins that plays you.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry, guys, but once again, thanks, guys, for joining the chat, stream today, guys. Really appreciate this. Yeah, the thing here is here in Farmville, we got lots of things going on, but mostly we're kind of focusing mostly on our weeklies right now. But we definitely have something planned for the fall, so stay tuned. We're gonna give you updates on that very soon. And we're actually planning to do a monthly, actually a seasonal monthly slash tournament. It's supposedly gonna be like Smash and FGC. But yeah, stay tuned. We definitely have updates for that. So, and there it is, the Nikito missile gimping Zay out of the stock there with Ice Climbers. I think this matchup is definitely really hard for Ice Climber just because of the projectiles that Snake puts out. And the fact that he's got to get in, the Ice Climber's definitely have to get in and get a grab. But other than that, I definitely would say that once they can put damage on Snake, it's definitely going to look like even playing field. That was a good up there, splitting both characters up, but... There's really good zoning coming from Zay, keeping space between both characters. Zay taking that second stock. 2-1 stock right now. Zay in the lead. Will Zay be able to continue his momentum and take the next stock? We'll have to find out here.
Oh, wow.
And there goes Nana. Here we have Sopo versus Snake. That was good covering both options. Yeah. Somehow, Sopo makes it back to the stage, regardless of having Nana or not. The second attempt he made a successful recovery. This is the thing about Sopo. I always get overwhelmed with Sopo, even though Sopo is it's just the one ice climber. I always get overwhelmed, and I cannot finish the last ice climber. But Sopo is definitely, oh wow, and Zay going for the sauce, but he just could not get the B special to work on the freeze. I bet he wishes he could utilize the freeze glitch and melee glitch. Oh, if only that was a thing in Ultimate. People would, I think Ice Climbers would be a very amazing character at that point. Yep. Oh wow. Chikimoto doing a really good job making a comeback here with both of them. The one hit on anything, a tilt or an up air, F smash, anything like that will confirm a stock here. 202. Oh my goodness. Chikimoto hanging on. Just going for work. Doing a really good job. And there it is. It was a good parry, but the multi-hit coming from both ice climbers taking that stock. Let's see what stage they're going to be going to, or counter-picking. Looks like we have a Kalos Pokemon lead. You know, I think Gen 6 was a really good Pokemon game. I think Gen 6 was a good Pokemon game. Like, I mean, I like Gen 6. I'm sorry, this the graphics from Gen 6 on the 3DS. The region and just Gen 6 in itself were I would say was slightly lackluster, but I don't know. Gen 5 was pretty good though. I like Gen 5. Gen 7. Yeah. Oh. Jigs versus Snake. I don't even know how, like, I don't know these matchups. These matchups are so. I could just definitely tell you that the matchup right here is definitely going to be hard for Jigs. But, like I said, no one really plays Jigs. Everyone plays, I see tons of Snakes, but no one usually does this. Oh, wow, that was a really good read coming from, potential read coming from Jimoto. Just so you guys know, Jimoto is a Snake Boxman coming from all the way from the DC area today to Smash Station here in Farm, Virginia, which is really awesome just to see more talent coming out, so that's great. Yeah. Zay having a really hard time getting in right now, trying to get that same man, and up to coming from Jimoto. Oh wow, he was a little late on the Smash there. RPG not hit. Jimoto going really high. We'll see what he gets from this. I'm thinking that was a tilt. Might have been a tilt.
Thank you.
J-Mo taking that second game there. 1-1. I love the game threes. Game threes are really good. Just to see how things will play out. A man of his game. Gotta love gentlemen. Ice climbers. Okay. So Zay's sticking with his guns. Oh, okay. King DDD versus Ice Climbers. You guys just keep throwing out these really idiotic matchups. I don't even know. I can't commentate on this. No one plays DDD. I'm like, wait, aren't these Big D's mains, or is he just Ice Climbers only? I know he used to be King DDD in Smash 4. Okay. Yeah. Wait, yeah, once again, we have J-Moto and Zay going to the game 3 here, and the characters of choice here are King DDD and Ice Climbers. Yeah, so if King DDD could use his Gordo offensively and more tactically, I think he could definitely get the advantage here. On FD. And there's the back coming from J-Moto. Taking that stock. Yeah, this stage, I definitely want to say one of the more wider stages. I think the ceiling in the blast zones are definitely a lot bigger than the regular FD. You can correct me on that if that's the correct something else. But yeah, it's good forward air coming from Zay there, Ice Climbers forward air. Honestly, if you could find a way to connect that a little bit more off, especially if you can read his options as shield, or sorry, after a throw, probably could get a spike move. Yeah, it seems Zay is really finding a lot of. Oh wow, there's the hammer coming, and there it is. He's charging up the hammer. Can he land it? Oh no, the Gordo. That's the one thing I don't like about, even though. King DDD's Gordo, I don't like how you can hit them back. The fact that can be his like his main weakness, or just the fact you can use that against him is just, I don't know, it just doesn't seem fair to me, but whatever. Yeah, they made him shoot his character, so that's good. They did the same thing with the same sort of thing with Ridley, where you can attack. If Ridley's mouth is open, you can attack him and do more damage. Oh, there it is, the up tilt coming from Zay there. Good job. The next second stop. We have an even game here. Let's see if either player can see who can take the last stock first. The last stock first. My commentating skills are amazing, by the way. S-ranked commentator right here. What's going on, dude? It's good to see you, man. Hey, so I don't know. We're gonna try to. I think we can swing a Street Fighter 5, right? I think we're gonna try to. We have 8 people here. Let's see how many we can do. If the worst is if we have like 4 people, we can just do like a round robin. Round robin don't take long.
I'll try to get Street Fighter downloaded on the system and take it to.
Okay, well, whatever you have, we'll just do free play, if whatever you want to do. But right now, yeah, we're doing Ultimate Singles right now, and this is round 2. We got started a little bit late. I was, like, getting here, and people weren't here either, so we had to wait. So, yeah. But what the heck to the match here? We have a last hit situation with King DDD. He's got to be really careful. Both characters have hammers. That's the thing about these kids, they both have hammers, like they have range. You know? Oh, I go for that dash attack. And there it is, the back air. J-Moto taking that game. Moving on to winners. The fact you both have, well, you have a hammer. He has a mallet, they have mallets. They're still powerful though. I need to play Pac-Man. No. You play your match. I'm just. He asked. I just had to let him know.
What's up, man? My old snake.
I'm ready. Alrighty guys, so this is S.A. Sash signing off for right now. I'm gonna do my match against S.H. Pac-Man. Two sync to your brethren. Alright.
Yo, Z, you gotta hop off.
Wait, is that my phone? Come on the phone.
Play some friendlies later though. Or almost, yeah.
Let's see. It'll be okay, Brian.
Who's my next match?
He really wants to know. We're giving you
the sports life. Right?
No,
or is they already played that?
No, they played already. He won.
Hold on a minute.
We really want to put you on stream. That's the one. Yo, if it is, we got to commentate. Yeah. It might be.
Oh,
man.
Really?
Who is it then? Oh, wait. Fuck. I don't know then. I might have to play B2. But, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Do you want me in the 2 hours then?
Sure, yeah, if you want to.
Alright.
How far are y'all in the ultimate
right? Right
far.
Oh, I got it.
hey, Jay Moto, do you want to play next? Do you want to play next, or did you want
to? You're playing me next.
Do you want to, like, open back? You want to go back to back, or?
Sure, might as well. I mean,
it's either we play or we get B2 and 501 to play. Because we want to put, one of my guys really wants to see B2 play because there's potential of him getting the result and leaving. B2.
We can have him go first.
Who?
We can have,
Oh, okay. Are you okay with playing again? Okay. Hey, B2, you're up, man.
I decided that.
No. We got people waiting. No one's gonna get upset. Everyone's waiting to watch you play. No, it's like one of my buddies on that I work with. He wants to see B2 play. Yeah. Yeah.
Hey, you're a professional streamer, right?
I'm not a professional streamer, but whatever. Oh, you can change it if you want. You can change it real quick. Oh my goodness. Dude, I love Okami HD. It's the greatest.
Oh man, he's pretty sure always in San Diego. I'm gonna use all his real estate, man. What'd you get into that? Make some money. Where you wanna go, man? PS2? Oh, yeah, Pokemon Stadium, yeah.
PlayStation 2 and Smash. Hey, Pac-Man, can I get you to come with me?
Okay, here we go. All right, who we got? We got our boy B2 fighting 501. All right.
Hello, gentlemen.
Go ahead, get in here.
We got really feeling it from Shulk. Okay.
This is losers round 2, and here we go. Oh shit.
We lagging over here a little bit.
I think I may have broke the string a little bit.
Tragic.
Yeah, it's tragic.
I hear a SD from B2. I hear KO, but will it connect?
I think he actually used it to get back to the stage.
Wow,
and
he actually made it back.
Yeah, he made it back to stage with that. That's actually a good recovery option, to be honest.
Oh, he counters. Man, that takes
I have a question.
I do have one question,
though. Is this the base Shulk?
It is very base Shulk.
But no.
I have not seen no Monado power.
Actually,
I see shield. I hear a side smash from Matt?
Yeah. And hey guys, we apologize. We're gonna try to fix this right after the smash, so we'll see you guys in the next game.
Exactly. I hear a lot of up tilt, it seems like.
Just a smidge.
Okay, a lot of down tilt here.
Did you switch one to an LP or something like that?
I hear a KO.
That might be it.
It might be.
What do you say?
I actually switched.
And KO punch takes the game.
KO punch takes the game.
So did somebody
do you play against the match or something?
Yeah, 501 taking that game was really good.
A whole bunch of like questions, John, right? A whole bunch of Johns.
It doesn't matter.
Sounds like someone's confident in their character.
Yeah. Solo Max.
This man is very confident in his character. I give him credit. So who will BT bit?
Hey guys, before you got a hey, BT, you mind putting the ass ratio back where it was? It's like really laggy.
It does. It's not your setup.
Yeah, you mind doing that real quick?
No, I can't play on these conditions. I need the whole real estate. Oh, you're trying to mess my matchup.
It doesn't work.
I need the whole aspect ratio.
No, you don't.
We're lagging, though.
Just the aspect ratio. Now your equipment
just
falls.
You have a 1080p.
Three, two, one. Go!
I think we're good, though.
It looks good over here now.
Yeah. I think it just needed him. We're actually good now, so it's all good.
Sorry, ladies and gentlemen, for this weird accusation. This man has yet to pick
Sonic.
His main. Like,
well,
he plays Link and Sonic. I'm not really sure,
but I also see how Samus coming. But anyway, back to the match.
Oh, Samus either.
Yeah, but anyway, back to the match. This Kirby versus Little Mac. Kirby's got a lot of combo potential.
Yeah,
and that was
yeah.
a really good recommit from B2 there. Yeah, like I said, this matchup is all about combos and just getting a move in that neutral. Yeah, that super armor came in. B2's got to definitely remember the super armor with Little Mac if he wants to walk away the win.
I'm just surprised he plays Kirby. I've never known him have a Kirby.
He played Kirby a lot in Smash 4, mostly just for matchups.
Super armor coming into effect again.
Yeah, that super armor is definitely really big, especially when you have something like Little Mac. And then most people tend to forget about Little Mac super armor. He's going for a charge forward smash. Something's going to do it.
Will a KO punch connect? Oh, and a good.
It barely missed. It barely grazed.
Okay.
Nair taking his time.
Wow,
he takes his own tying it up for whatever reason he tied it up for. I don't know why he needs to rest.
Side smash connects.
Yeah, he said he's trying to make it interesting. On the contrary.
A lot of upbeat on some of my first curve.
Trying to get that range.
And he's also just trying to reset the neutral. Not really sure why he's not stealing the power. The power is actually pretty good if you get it. Oh, and that is the KO punch.
KO
B2.
Punch.
Happened, happened. That was a good match.
Good match. Good match. You tried bringing her back. Good match. Good match.
Yeah, my guy. My guy. So we're going into sleep mode. What is this? Why? Why are we going into sleep mode, B2?
Well, B2 and his saltiness. Yep. Saltiness review.
Hey, what's going on, man? How you doing? Pretty good.
Also, for the I read that last game.
Yeah, yeah.
So hard.
That's why I wanted to do it. Hey, I told you.
That's numeric salt.
Yes, yes.
Not 5 or 1.
Oh, man. And so we have a weekly tournament here every Tuesday. Yeah, we start usually from 6 o'clock and go all the way to 12 a.m. And we actually have, we're a separate group called Synced Heroes. We have a Twitch page and also Discord and Facebook. If you look us up, it's Synced_Heroes. Yeah, I'll actually give you if you want to check this out.
Even, no, like, no, back in the back. There's nothing.
So the like the landing and everything, you capitalized on it. You were like perfect. Every time I landed, you would just like take the stock off. I think it's just when I get one whiff punish, anything like up tilt, it ends up like anything that I touch you with, it ends up putting you in the air. If you can find a way to land safely, which is like one of Matt's biggest issues, like landing safely, I think that would be like the way to go. So like getting away from anything like that. Also grabbing when you see Falcon shoot. I think that's possible.
Yeah. I always forget that that's armor because it's such a character trait for me. It's something that you should never do.
Yeah, a lot of mats.
Even if it's multi-hits, it's the one thing that it does really well.
Because you can shield grab like, right after, so you can cancel the shield. So that's like one thing. So like, if I was trying to anti-air you, and you can choose to be.
Okay.
You literally, it has no utility except like a shield break punish, which the forward smash does that. So it just goes without something else.
Why is that character?
Why is that character in the game? It's a trash character.
I can't do it. No, I don't even care about what that is. He's like anti-human. But he's not safe.
Did you see this?
He's literally just
thank you. Thank you. Thank you. super low with the laser, and I'm like, I know I can make that. Yeah, you know.
Yeah, all your characters are extremely good.
Oh my gosh.
Definitely good stuff.
I'll play you.
Cool. Yo, we gotta, like, hey, Pac-Man L, did you guys play already?
Yeah.
Okay. What was the, who?
Zero.
Okay.
Wait, who won?
Hey, L. You said L one? Alright, hey L, can you play Zay on stream?
Yeah. Oh, that time.
What time is it, Beyonce?
9:45.
Around what time do you think you're gonna be out of here? Like, approximately.
Probably before 12.
Mm-hmm. Before 12. Late. So at least 11:30.
I think 11:30.
Between 11 and 11:30.
10:45.
I don't know about that, but yeah, we'll probably.
Depends on if anybody gets waxed. Like, damn, you're freaking hard to play against, dude. You're adaptation.
Yeah, I do. That's what I usually focus on. I focus on just adapting and just trying to win neutral. Winning neutral is very important to play. And if you can learn all the combos in the world and learn how to get people very easily. But you can win neutral and just be overwhelmingly neutral. You can more than likely win the match.
Sounds like a ball for me.
Yeah. So when you go to playing show, I'd say if you can beat people with neutral, you'll make an even playing field easier. So I'd say focus on that.
All those D-sinks are luck, huh?
Oh my gosh.
Wow.
How?
No, he just dashes luck, back and presses a button and it just happens.
Luck-based ice climbers? I can't fathom that.
You do know that move hits every 3 frames, right? You're always stopping people from jumping at you with that blizzard. You're always that. No other ice climbers players do that. Like, even Big D doesn't do that in like ice climbers. Like, stop people from jumping.
I like how it's very game about this.
He's alive.
Hey.
Buddy, guys.
3, 2, 1, go!
Yeah, you're not out. Yeah.
Oh yeah, yeah.
I'm sorry if we didn't explain that.
What are the losers matches?
You're right here. So you're the
loser. Loser's final? Oh, alright. So the
So you'll either get you're in top three right now.
Uh-huh.
So you'll either get third, second, or first if you're winning it. In order to get first, you'll have to make a bracket reset. So you
yeah,
have
I
to
know
go.
How reset.
Okay, yeah, that's what I was like.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. So yeah, yeah. You yeah. Congrats. You already made it top three. So yeah.
Top three is A.
Is that 1-1?
Yeah.
Okay. Hey guys, when you get a chance, can you change the aspect ratio so we can not someone be so laggy? Cause it's like really, my Switch is struggling. It's like freaking out. Oh my gosh, that is so much better.
Yeah.
It's like 100%, it's like perfect right now. I can't even tell you. This is like, that was a problem the whole time, I think. Yeah, it's like that. And it don't be that way. I don't know, I'm gonna check the chat and see if someone flipped it though. I
feel sorry for anybody. I'm not even gonna say I feel sorry. I apologize to anybody that was that messaged the chat.
Yes,
it's strictly, but it is so much better. Those parries were really good. Parrying both moves from Popo and Nana. Let's see. And Popo is gone just like that. A back air sending him flying. Now walking away that game 3-1. I can't. Wait. Actually, I might be able to on my phone. Where's Patty? Alright, so it'll get all the credit that it truly reserved. Wait, did you already, you saved it?
Yeah, I saved it.
Okay, guys. But while we're waiting.
I don't hate him. He beat me in like the first turn.
Damn.
So, dude, you
have.
No. I mean, you wouldn't like that.
I'm sorry, guys. We had to reevaluate some things. Your goal has been successfully achieved. Hey, 501, you're playing against L next. Hey, if you want to play friendlies with other guys over there, that'd be great if you could. Real quick before he leaves. Oh, download it?
He's downloading.
Oh, no.
He's going to lead you here to death, man, in about 30 seconds and stop.
Oh, come on now.
Sashbacks. I love that.
You should know what to do this time.
Go!
seen the game.
Hey, 501, so you're in losers finals against J-Mo. Whatever you're ready. Best of three. I mean, no, I'm sorry, best of five. Would you like to commentate? All right. Go ahead with this.
All right, I'm just going to say just one thing. This little man causes problems. That's all I got to say.
I think I can agree with you there, because little man is honestly... I mean, there's a point in time where I actually did not like playing little man back in Smash 4. But, yeah, you know, some tough times, you know. You got to get through the tough times. But, yeah, we got a little Mac Ditto here, and I was not expecting this today. Oh, wow. It's like a counter versus a... was that a counter versus a counter? Or counter versus punish? I don't even know. But 501 was on the stage just saying, hey, man, you can't just cheese me out of my back. And there it is. Remy. Okay.
I just met this guy, Remy, but he's pretty awesome.
And there it is, Remy. Yeah. Dude, you're on your way out of the venue. We're going to have to ask you to leave the premise.
Like,
this is a crime.
It kind of is. Two little men fighting each other.
All right, so J-Modo's got the KO punch right now. Let's see what he's going to do with it. Will he utilize it well, or will he...
Nope.
Oh, unfortunately, he loses it.
Oh, that was a good game.
One of the things that I'm really good with doing is just capitalizing on tilts and confirm.
Yeah, the down tilts really bugged the mess. I mean, they reached a lot farther than I ever imagined, to be honest.
Yeah, I just like how he has no fear of using the board smash whenever he needs to use it. Super Armor coming to play to get solid damage. It's always reliable.
And I like how they do that two punch when they slide. Like, I think that's kind
of
cool.
Oh yeah, that's like some type of option swag or some really neat tech. It's new to Ultimate, honestly. But and there it is, the side of me finish, taking that stop. Yeah, that Ditto was definitely unexpected. I didn't even know J-Modo had a Mac, but. Wait, hold on. It's not going to Okay. So here we go with game two. Full screen. Look, I don't know what this shit says. But it said full screen. It's a lie. It's just like black. Like gray. That's black.
I guess.
All right, so we got Snake versus Little Mac. I think this matchup will definitely be Snake's favorite.
I expect the Snake, like every other Snake I've ever seen, is just a hide and throw.
Yeah, that sounds like a Snake. I hate Snakes sometimes.
And then constantly really do up smash against the edge.
No, Snakes is actually really cool to see because their combos, or no, the reads that they make, they're like galaxy brain level. It's like they already have you. They already have everything mapped out. It's like there's no need to fight them because they're gonna hit you with all these projectiles and weapons. Oh wow, this Mac is definitely putting a lot of damage on Snake right now. If he can find a way to T frame that. And there it is.
KO punch.
Yeah, that was really good. Probably doing a really good job pressuring Little Mac. I'm sorry, pressuring Snake right now. And one of the biggest issues for Mac is just landing safely. Finding a way to land safely, if you can find that, you'll have half the battle figured out. Simply because if they can't punish you, then you're safe.
Because, like, he, 501, he really knows how to time his, like, his super armor.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, a lot.
And that there is a good dash attack over Snake. One of the things that's probably the most annoying about that is the fact that it crosses the shield. And when I say that, it goes through the shield.
It does?
Yeah, it basically, when he does like a dash attack, he'll go right past the shield. That's what I mean by cross up. And see, when moves cross up like that, they can be hard to punish because you might not be ready to punish something like that. You might be ready to punish something that's like right in front of you, not something that's going to go past you.
He took the stock with an up B.
Yeah,
and chase up B.
Okay, what they said, Little Mac got some air game. He got
he got that air game. It's not the greatest, but he got that air game. That's all that matters. And this Carol Punch, see what's going to happen here.
Ooh.
Right. And it's weird because I thought they kept it for Smash 4, like you had to be like above 30 in order for it to kill. But like, I got hit by that thing. I died at like 20 with Luigi.
It also depends on like weight class and also DI. I'm not really sure. I just know that like at certain percents for some characters, they might be a little bit longer.
Oh wow! Okay. Well, I really enjoy finding his little maggots. It keeps my brain moving, I tell you that.
It's definitely something that keeps you on your toes. You can't, go the entire match without, thinking. Yeah, there are characters that are, rather brain dead that you can play that are, super simple. But this matchup right here, this will make you even think. Even with a brain dead character, it'll make you think. So, here we go with Game 3. CJ Mono can bring this back. Sticking with Snake versus Thunder back here. But yeah, back to this match. We're going to Town and City. I think this definitely is a state that
favors. Ooh, nice parry with the down tilt.
I think this is definitely something that the state favors more Snake than Little Bear. It's very good.
Oh wow!
Damage is damage.
What I haven't seen yet is that after he does get a grab and he doesn't chase it with a down B and plant it on him. That's what a lot of snakes do.
Yeah, a lot of snakes. Yeah, they do that. Surprised he didn't actually go Pokemon Snake 2. I think that's a better stage. But either way, it's 5-1 is definitely a match.
To us for a side smash. I think he does know how to read a lot of from where people are gonna go if they do anything.
Yeah, that was a really good spot. I'm sorry, dodge coming from Giannotto there. Could have easily taken his stock away with the KO punch.
I mean, he's still in the game. I ain't gonna give up on him yet.
Yeah, I'm not either. I definitely think. Or tilt coming from Little Mac, sometimes it hits really well. It's because it hits twice, and the fact that the way he positions himself, when he does, when he throws out deep punches, and it just makes for good damage and good connection.
I thought he was gonna go for a spike right there after he launched it with the side B. Oh!
The KO punch. Well, good games coming from both players. I say 5-1 has grand.
And I'm guessing that's you who's taking the seat with him? It is right, people. We got SA Sash.
We got Sash versus 501.
It's good to be here, man. It's good to be here. Come on, make sure they see your face.
I'm gonna let him see me.
All
right. So I just got waxed by this man's Little Mac like moments ago. Even though I was able to at least take a game off Sash, and Sash was able to beat him, you know. Little Mac, very polarizing character. Definitely punishes you for having bad habits a lot. You know what other character does that, but is also marginally better? Dr. Mario. So we're gonna see how this goes. Alright, basic neutral start. Someone getting up tilted by Little Mac at least twice.
Well, the thing about Sash is he's really. Mm-hmm. Like, his Dr. Power is really, really dangerous. It's like, okay. With
commentator's curse.
Alright.
Commentator's curse. I like
it. Sorry.
Oh, Little Mac's got the X Factor.
Ooh, wow.
The thing is, Little Mac does have true confirms into KO Punch. However,
don't you have to be at a certain percentage?
The windows are decently tight if you know how to DI. So, you know, that is on the table for Little Mac whenever he gets KO Punch. He doesn't always have to go for the hit in neutral. Wow, I actually took that back air.
He, whenever he smashes, he's like, his smash gives him enough space to like not get grabbed to get punished afterwards.
Yeah, exactly. Though you one thing to note, Little Mac's super armor does not start up on frame one. Moves that Little Mac throws out actually can be interrupted if you pressure him, but he also has non-super armor moves that are very fast. That makes that a very difficult strategy to adhere to if you're gonna try and deal with the super armor. We got another SD.
I'm thinking that I feel like this Dr. Mario is trying to make up for that SD. Yeah, with a down tilt. So you got it.
Yep, he stole his jump with the down tilt side B. It's stolen.
Okay.
Yep. Is it up tilt or down tilt?
No, it is a spot dodge
down tilt. Oh, yeah, the hurt box shifting just before the spot dodge.
You got that.
That's wow, that is really, really good.
So what was just said to you? Because I didn't
hear was just said? Okay, so basically Little Mac does have an interesting KO punch confirm. I forgot the name that he just gave it to me, but if Little Mac does a spot dodge and then performs up tilt, was it? Down tilt. Does a spot dodge and then performs a down tilt. It actually shifts his hurt box and subsequently the hitbox, apparently, which allows it to very consistently combo into KO punch. That is, That is very specific, and I did not think that hurt box shifting would actually change where the hitbox was, but hey, you know, learn something new every day.
And
for some reason, no one bans the stage against Little Mac. But hey, you know, Little Mac.
Final Destination for me is like the best stage for me to go to. Cause, you know,
versus Little Mac?
Well, yeah, against any character, because like, that's just how it is. I don't really go into the max about it. Shows how unprofessional I am. Mm-hmm. But,
I see what you mean. Though, like, one weakness that Little Mac does have is, like, lacking safe platform pressure and then getting people off of platforms, as well as getting himself off. Every weakness Little Mac has literally disappears on this stage. So, you're playing against an equivocal mid-tier version of Little Mac when fighting him on this stage, which can be pretty bad. Pretty bad. Yep, nice raw KO punch. He's definitely really, really good at, like, catching on to whether or not people are either scared of the KO punch or, you know, if they've already committed to an action to deal with him with the KO punch. So it's definitely a move you have to give it its weight. You know, like, if you fear KO punch too much, then obviously you're just going to get hit by it when you press a bad button. But if you respect it too much, then you give Mac a ton of space to use all of his other moves and potentially lead into a confirm with it. So, you know, always something to watch out for. He's nairing out of those up tilts now, which is good because if I remember correctly, Doc and normal Mario's nairs are frame 2, which is faster than their air dodges. So that's definitely good to deal with a low percent up tilt. Wow, cape in the grab. Wow, an approaching cape. That was very ballsy, because if he waited that out, that would have been very negative.
But it's actually just leaves 77%, and yeah.
Oh, yep. There's that kill throw. You know, got the whiff punish on that tilt. You know, maybe a little bit of a.
I like how he did earlier, how he managed to take it. Like, he kept playing spaces with the pill, mm-hmm. and that's like really because this Lil Mac has to be up close to you.
Exactly. But once again, you got that FD pick, and Lil Mac doesn't. Oh my god! The million IQ cape, except for the fact that it was only decent IQ because Lil Mac is not a good kid. So yeah, one thing he was doing really well in that matchup was, one problem I had, for some reason, even though I normally do this against Little Mac players, but I guess the jitters got to me, is that you really want to just use your drift to deal with a juggle rather than air dodging, because Little Mac is way too fast to be air dodging, for you to be air dodging, because like, even though neutral air dodge only has 5 frames of lag, Little Mac's like the third fastest like character in like the whole game. So, and he's got really fast moves, so if any character can trap a landing from neutral air dodge, it's Little Mac. So I'm really liking how Sash is using his air mobility, he's using the little bit of air mobility Doc has to just move away from him rather than like try to air dodge on landing like I was doing in my set with him far too much.
Yeah, I get it, because like, I think that's...
Is that his jump? No. Yeah, that's his jump.
Yeah.
Hit the jump.
Like... Dr. Mario is kind of like a mini Ganondorf plus Mac, because his recovery is definitely not the greatest, like his regular self. But like, I guess they took his recovery away for the power he got.
Yeah, you know.
Yeah,
we got KO punch on the table once again. Oh, he just burns it. Maybe he thought he was going to land onto the platform, since KO punch does indeed hit on the platform.
With a nice punch of the missed up B.
Yep.
Ooh,
oh,
wow,
the
I
instant
like
wall jump pill. Okay, Sash styling on him a little bit. Mm-hmm. One thing I also like that he's doing that I definitely was like doing very poorly in my set, pills are a considerably worse, and that's a reverse up B. But anyway, pills are considerably worse of a projectile than like Snake's Nades, because Snake's Nades are very, very versatile. However, one thing he's doing way better than me with a far worse projectile is he's not overzoning. So he's not just trying to like pill camp him and backpedal and then take space based off of that. You know, he's using it in very specific situations where he knows that Little Mac won't be able to deal with the pill. Caught him DI'ing that away just a little bit, not a lot, because obviously he didn't kill him, but he was DI'ing away on that back throw for just a moment.
The nice one. And he does have that.
And he just
26.
Neutral
get up
KO
rage.
Punch. Oh man. Yep.
Alright.
See it. Listen, Mr. 501, Mr. 501 here is about to get a bracket reset. He only needs one more game. Oh, but I was talking to him. I was talking about the zoner, the proper zoning. And now that he's playing a character that's much better at zoning, with a lot more mobility. So, you know.
I have bought this man's tooling, and I'm telling you, it is not the funnest thing in the world.
I almost
brawl all over again.
No, we do not have brawl. We do not have brawl Toon Link here. He's not glide tossing with bombs across stage and doing.
I mean, you are correct, but it's, the strain is equally
equally strenuous. I came very, very close, but ultimate, of course, randomly decides when things will and won't cross up, and my up smash just went right behind him. Feels bad. Literally, he was at 100 too, so like that was the game. I read the neutral get up, but I slid behind him. So, you know, that's my B.
It's still pretty. Oh, never mind.
Oh, yeah?
Not here anymore. Sash lost it to a four smash. And he still has that KO punch, so
he's got that X factor.
Trying to hold it.
Oh, lost it. Lost it to the boomerang. Let's see. Ah, yeah, that's good corner pressure. So he did the He did an F tilt, like, right at ledge in order to, like, bait an option out because he couldn't punish it, and then he threw the forward smash up. So what he's one thing he's doing is, like, he's really trying to condition you to do an option preemptively rather than react to what Little Mac has, which makes it a lot easier. And there's another landing counter. He's gotten away with a lot of these over the course of the tournament.
He really knows when to use it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely. You know, he knows, like, when people get really anxious to try and trap Mac's landing since it's, like, something he's really bad at. But, you know. I mean, hey, when you have the mental fortitude to play this character for some reason... you know, it makes sense that you'd be able to catch reads like that. Oh, we got one more KO punch online. Could be a stock.
Oh,
anti-air
wow.
KO the punch.
Three, with the three stock
oh,
win.
Oh, man.
And it is now a record reset.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a reset. So, you know, here we are, hoping that, you know, both players learn from something that last match. You know, people talk about adaptation.
Here it comes.
Wow.
The has emerged.
He waited for the reset.
That's why I give it a try.
All right. Now, one thing to note is that the last time he played his Falco, it went very bad. And on FD, no less. So we're going to see... We're gonna see if he has made any adjustments, and see if this Mac can deal with this Falco. Spaceys are really, really good at dealing with Little Mac because their fall speed allows them to, like, you know how I was talking earlier about how Little Mac is with, like, trapping landings, whatever. Well,
oh, wow, jeez.
Oh my God.
Not giving him any chance to breathe.
The destruction, jeez. But Spaceys are really, really good against Little Mac because their fall speed and the projectiles they have all have different value in this matchup. Basically, it's really difficult for Little Mac to contest projectiles, like, directly. He's a fast character, right? But since he can't jump at people, right, if they decide to jump out of disadvantage, which Falco's really good at since he has the highest full hop,
oh, wow,
they
actually made that back.
I don't know how. This ultimate with the magnet and the SD. See, I'm over here trying to commentate, and then just, like, the tone of the match just changes over and over and over again.
No, but the down tilt side beat takes a lot more damage.
Mm-hmm. Actually, he has been hitting some untrue ones, like ones that don't really, ones that lose to air dodge, but beat jump, since, you know, like, jump's not invincible. So that's one thing he's been doing quite a bit, is, like, he's been beating jump with, like, the down tilt side Bs. And people, you're conditioned to jump, like, right at the beginning, at low percent when you're getting hit with the down tilt. Because you don't want to get hit with, like, anything else. You don't want to get hit with a smash attack, right? So when he does it and decides to do side B, that catches your jump very easily because you've already been conditioned to jump it over and over and over again.
So, like, what Sash is doing, he's not really playing Spaceys, but he's just keeping Little Mac off stage, like, to where, like, so you won't have a chance to, like, get able to recover.
Mm-hmm. And in neutral, he's definitely gotten a lot better at trapping these landings, especially, like, with this up tilt. We haven't really seen much of that, even in the beginning of this match in particular. Good to see a nice amount of adaptation. Another landing counter. He misses that down tilt side B. Nice forward throw, robbed him the KO punch. Forward throw again. He's doing a lot of grabs. You know, not. Oh my God. Wait, he's still alive? Does he have it? Nope. Stole it with the laser. Yeah, the Falco's easily doing a lot better. A lot better than last match. A lot better than last Lots of landing on the platforms, too. I noticed that a lot. Like, he was landing on platforms instead of just landing on stage. Mm-hmm. And while I went to Town and City, like, you can do that a lot against Little Mac, right? When I fought him. But one problem is that, like, Town and City has that one transformation where there's no platforms, and landing against Little Mac becomes very difficult. And he has so much space to run away with, you know? So he was definitely making use of those platforms on PS2 very, very well.
Mm-hmm. All right. Match number two.
Match number two. We got the color counter pick. He let him go to FD again. But hey, you know.
This time he took the jacket off, so he was kind of happy. Now he's feeling himself.
Well, as a wise man once said, pink jackets are for losers. I'm literally going to be the only person who gets that wrong.
And that is, I guess so. I never heard that before.
That is
from an old movie or something?
Nah, it's from the guy playing right now. Yep, went for an untrue back air to up tilt. That is never a thing ever, even though it would be really cool if it was, but nope, back air up tilt, not a thing. He recognized that and went for the counter. Got shield grab for going for that side B. It's likely that he expected it. Oh, that was an amazing counter. Another side B back air. Oh, try to trap the landing with the up B. That is a very interesting choice.
Ooh, what a nice tech against the stage.
He's got to watch it, challenging that recovery, because that side B has a lot of knockback, and it will become untechable like very soon, and only a few more percent, especially if Rage gets involved. And these grabs, dude, the grabs are helping out so much, because like the grabs circumvent the super armor. He doesn't have to worry about super armor if he's going for good grabs. He's definitely using the air game a lot better. But there's that forward tilt.
Two punch.
Little two punch. One of Mac's fastest moves. It is insane. It is an insanely quick move. Obviously, it kills super hard. Cut his jump.
I like how he waited to, instead of doing it back here. Waited for a counter of smash kill takes.
Yep, finally caught one of these landing counters. You know, we were talking about how he picks his spots with these landing counters very well, but you know, Sash picking up on it. Ooh, but up B's cleaning the stage. Falco actually has limited angles on his side B. Like, he can't do 360 degrees fully. There are set angles. So, you know, if this was, like, Melee or something, then, yeah, he would be able to do a slightly lower angle to snap the ledge. But it was actually impossible for him to snap the ledge from that angle unless he waited. So, you know, good recognition from 501, you know, reacting to that and hitting him with that forward smash.
I like Falco's approach by not trying to get in way too close, but just, like, getting a couple beams in there. Oh, nice. I hear it.
Oh, we got the ding ding. Oh, yep. Right on cue, at least for the stream time. But hey, he caught it. Oh, my God. caught him for doing the incredibly laggy counter that is not a good move.
Had a double.
In space.
All right.
Yep. Sash going with no stage bans because he's confident and that he's figured out this matchup. So, you know, it's after reset. We're 2-0. You know, maybe if you've got some secondaries in the back pocket.
All right. I got you, Sebastian. I'll do that back. Mm-hmm.
Yep. Go for it. Mm-hmm. Yep. So, Little Mac, this Little Mac player, showing more and more skin as the game goes on. Before, he started off with a jacket, then his skin, but he decided to just take his skin off. Put an end to it. So yeah, you know, hey, everything's off now, you know, everything except for the gloves. All right, they're trying to deal with this controller issue. Listen. Wired controllers are the truth. Wireless controllers, unless they're Joy-Cons, which are very easy to sync and unsync, if it's for the specific setup. Listen, I am so done with these pro controllers at these tournaments. People have pro controllers, and they're trying to sync them and resync them, and they don't desync them when they're off of a setup. You know, hey, I'm just saying, GameCube, you know, it's legit. You know. I mean, honestly, to each their own, but desync your controllers, man. Please desync your controllers. Make things easier for the TOs. All right. Mm-hmm. We need to have brawl one of these days.
Yes, please.
One of these days, some brawl.
All right, I have returned to me. Resident Evil 8?
Nice, all right. Resident Evil 8 hype, I guess.
All right, people.
Well, we have potentially the last game of this tournament, with Sash winning, potentially, or we might have an actual comeback coming from this little mech. To my knowledge, he actually won the last one of these that you guys had, right?
Oh, yes, he did.
Yes, he did, so, you know. Amen. Going into this one, Sash definitely, this is definitely the culmination of all of his knowledge from the past couple games. He's definitely figured out a lot of how to deal with this matchup. He's not getting caught slipping, you know, with lots of the basic little Mac traps. You know, he's landing a little bit more preemptively. He caught that air dodge with the upbeat like he's been waiting for, finally. So, you know, hey, he might have the download, or, you know, if an adjustment can be made, you know, we might have a reverse three on
it. Connects the down. He connected the down tip, but didn't get the side B.
Ooh, yep, there it is, the raw KO punch. That forward smash, likely a reaction. You know, the forward smash was very gutsy. It's likely he was trying to catch a landing on stage. Stole that KO punch from him with the side B.
That's the little Max just does not want to go. At 187 rage.
Oh my god, Max,
this sock,
Max rage, little Mac.
Oh, this is going to be dangerous.
Yeah, this is one problem like Falco does have. Because Falco doesn't have a kill throw or anything like that, it's very difficult for him to get kills without just getting like a raw hit in the neutral. But, you know, speaking of raw hits, we got that back air.
What?
More nooch. We got a nice little B&B up throw back air. He tried to cover himself with the counter, but Sash didn't bite because he stole his jump with that up throw back air. He didn't bite the counter. He's definitely made the adjustment, but no, the whiff from the KO punch. We're going to see what he does with this lead.
The down throw.
Won't take too much now.
It's so close.
F tilt. F tilt that ledge will do it. Up tilt bear will now kill as Falco. So if that's on. But the F tilt. Okay. The F tilt takes the game.
Not
3-0. Listen, don't sleep on Little Mac. You can't sleep on Little Mac. He might not take everything, but. No, you can, like, Little Mac is not a great character, but, like, I feel Ultimate is balanced enough to where, with the right mindset, a lot of characters can do stuff. Now, Little Mac is the farthest stretch of that, but it is doable. I think a Little Mac could top 8 a major, maybe, in some crazy universe with a right bracket, with a right racket, with no peaches, no setup. Listen. No setup characters, and no characters that are majorly like aerial based, and Little Mac could top it in.
Can they put that 2K on real quick? Sorry, guys, I was trying to play 2K with somebody who definitely has no knowledge of it.
because he got him for the switch, which is disgraceful of unbelief. But back to Smash, though.
Yeah, back to Smash. You know, oh, what? Grab? He hasn't been grabbing a lot in this matchup. Granted, Little Mac doesn't get a lot off a grab, but it will stop people from sitting in shield. As you can saw, you know, we saw two consecutive neutral get up shields right there. So, you know, he's finally calling it out. Barely misspaced that down smash. Maybe he was catching an air dodge in, maybe not. Once again, you know, KO punch online. Oh, whiffs the up smash. And he just rolls back.
I feel like 5-1-1 is getting the hang of this Falco.
Yeah, he's definitely getting a handle. It's definitely better than it was, but it was definitely better than it was before.
Like, I don't know what they're thinking, but I feel like they're playing spaces with each other a little bit. Like, they both don't want to go at each other, like, full blast on.
Oh, there's another stolen jump with side B. There it is, down tilt side B, stealing jumps every game. There is something that can be done against both Little Mac side B and up B as Falco. It is hilariously broken, and because they can probably hear me, I will not talk about it, but there is a very easy way to challenge that recovery as Falco specifically. And maybe I'll talk about it after this set goes down. This might even be a reverse 3-0. I mean, I'm definitely seeing a lot of the adjustments. Empty hopping as Little Mac. Little Mac doesn't really have a real mix-up if he jumps at you and lands. Like, he's obviously just going to land and press a button. But if you're not expecting it, you can definitely be caught off guard by Little Mac just suddenly being in the air when he's known to be this ground fighter. So, you know.
Falco could really bring the stock back if he plays his cards right.
Oh, yeah, 100%. It's just like, yep, there's the F-tilt. That's exactly what I was about to start talking about. You know, F-tilt, it has a very interesting, it has a trample property, which means it beats any move that deals less damage than it, as well as being an incredibly fast move. So, makes sense. Yeah, we're definitely seeing a lot more dashbacks. He's working his lead a lot more. He is going in, like, he's not... Oh my god, wow. That is an unfavorable trade if I've ever seen one. You definitely don't want that.
I thought they both were gonna die for a minute.
Oh, so nice. Jump, called out the counter. But hey man, there's that.
Takes it. Hey, either it could go to another match, or it could be ended right here, so. But Little Mac can definitely bring his back once he gets there.
If he gets KO?
Yeah, because that KO, that could definitely be it.
He's already orange, just a little bit more. Oh.
And there it goes.
KO punch is online. It won't kill at 8. It will not kill at 8. It will, however, kill at 25. Oh, just barely. This could be it. All right, he's working. He's trying to work this.
It is Rage Max, so he could come back within, like, 4-2 moves, if possible.
Oh, up tilt, up air to catch the jump. And there we go. Sash takes it. 3-1.
I had a feeling like I was going to probably either get combo.
I want to fight your Leatherback. I want to fight your Leatherback again. Alright.
Nice. Well, that was pretty sick.
Good mental fortitude.
Thank you.
Three, Yeah. Yeah. and, you know, direct this shit. Suck. I'm directing today, goddammit. Who headphones? Ah, shit. All right, I'm cool.
I might be keeping these, Elliot.
Yeah, I will. Ugh. First things first, I'ma need that shirt. I'ma need that shirt. That's my team. I'ma need that shirt. What's going on with you, Andy? I feel you. At this point in time, you know, Sash sucks. You know, he's a butt, but he's still my homeboy. Are they wireless?
Yes.
What are you at? I get paid tomorrow. Where are you going? Like, I need to know where, like, to meet you. To, like, I'm going to GameStop sometime tomorrow. No, in Farmville. Depends on whenever my ride comes. Why? I don't trust niggas. Not that long. I know Elliot longer. So? You still was a bitch. You bitch when I stayed over. Yes, you did. Elliot told me. You was bitching. How was we making you bitch? We didn't even do nothing. We didn't even eat none of your food. We ordered food from Domino's. We shared with you. We was nice enough to share with you. I felt like you felt some type of way that me and my two friends stayed over. Cause, nigga, we don't steal. So you was upset? Other two guys. It was two. But they were cool, though. Well, now you know they're cool. Shit. Hey, did you win $25? Elliot, did you win? Did you win the $25?
Thank you.
He told me. Does it really matter why I know about it? Oh, he about to beat you now, Elliot. He in Super Saiyan mode. Psych. We should have it on that Mortal Kombat game over there. Been a woman. My nigga Sash just lost. Damn. It's 11:38. Niggas about to leave. The first one, and they say this, huh? Because they're retarded. They didn't, but still, they said that you're supposed to play the second one before you play the first one. They said the second one is the prequel to the first one. They said the second one is the prequel to the first one.
Rachel?